What's up, guys? It's Artie Star bringing out Clash Clans video today. Today's video is about a not a controversy, but something that Supercell should think about fixing within Clash of Clans. So we had two Town Hall 9s recently go to Town Hall 10, and we'll look at the first guy here, Stormlife. He's got all his stuff on the side here that he's got from the new Town Hall 10 stuff. He's got his Infernos here. Pay close attention to the Infernos. He's got one Inferno there. And then when we go back, we have another guy here, Brian. And we look at his. He's got both his Infernos going in. Plus, I believe he's got all his walls in already. And Archer Tower. Plus Cannon and all that stuff. And then we're a 24/7 war clan, so we got into a war when they were both Town Hall 9 before they went to Town Hall 10, and we got matched up against Town Hall 9s here, and what happened was Brian got Town Hall 10 first, and then Stormlife got Town Hall 10 second, but this came after we had already matchmaked the war, and when you scout this, his Infernos are in the war, both of them, and he hasn't even had them built in his regular base. So now we have a huge unfair advantage within this war. Another guy joined our clan from the opposing clan, just kind of talked to us about it. He also just commented on the Town Hall 7 base reviews video that I put up earlier about just expressing kind of how disadvantaged it was, and I agreed with him. When you put two Infernos up and they only have Town Hall 9s, and you're basically a Town Hall 9 and you're still building the Infernos within your base, it's kind of a little unfair. I don't know why Supercell does this. I'm kind of interested as what their thought process was. I remember when I was going to Town Hall 9, I built my two Expos, and as they were still building, they got put in the war and were functional. You can see that Stormlife also has Inferno here. I thought it was just kind of interesting, and I probably wouldn't have made this video unless the enemy team didn't come over and try to talk to us about it. And they made a good point, but it's like nothing you can really do. We didn't try to screw over our opponent or anything like that. We just ended up like that, and we didn't even think about having that in there. I remember it happened to me in the past, and you know, you kind of feel bad for the enemy team, but it is what it is. Kind of fortunate on our part, but yeah, hopefully Supercell notices this. Unless it's something that is meant to happen, I don't really know. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I'll be bringing you more content later. And yeah, have a good day. Peace out. Yeah.